guest speaker Dr. Jailan Shastri sir to grace the dais. It is my immense pleasure to introduce eminent personality and one of the stalwarts of Ayurveda, Dr. Jailan Shastri sir. Sir is currently designated as the head of healthcare research in Dabur Research and Development Center, Saidabad. He is a distinguished Ayurvedic scholar having a global vision for Ayurveda. He hails from a traditional Ayurvedic family of Andhra Pradesh. Sir has completed BAMS in 1989 from Dr. NRS Government Ayurvedic College, Vijayawada. Sir has pursued MD in Dravyaguna from Dr. BRKR Government Ayurvedic College, Hyderabad in 1998. His PhD dissertation entitled Database on Substitutes in Ayurveda with special reference to comprehensive study of substitutes of Pushkaramula has been submitted at Tilak Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya, Pune University in the year 2011. Sir has possessed a vast wealth of experience both in academics and industry. He is a recipient of 2 gold medals from Nagarjuna University, including the Best Thesis Award for his dissertation entitled Cardiac Diseases and Their Management Through Ayurveda. He has presented several clinical and scientific papers at regional, national and international seminars with more than 30 publications in reputed journals and newspapers. He has also given radio talks and guest lectures at various prestigious institutes. He has spearheaded many R&D activities in course of his association with the industry. He has a passion for teaching and has been involved in designing, developing and customizing training programs, teaching curriculum for the students of various UG and PG institutes of Ayurveda in India. He has authored more than 20 books, including 40 years of research in Ayurveda in AP. Sir was one of the editors of the first issue of newsletter Ayurveda Heritage, later renamed as Info. On behalf of Sri Jayendra Saraswati Ayurveda College and Hospital, I wholeheartedly welcome you, sir. I call up Dr. Uday Kumar, sir, Assistant Professor, Department of Komarabhritya, to honor the guest speaker, Dr. Jayendra Saraswati, sir.
धनवंतरीय नमः, सभाय नमः। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थैंक्स फॉर द गुड वर्ड्स। आई डोंट नो वेदर दे आर रियली रिक्वायर्ड और आई डिजर्व इट, बट एनीवे थैंक्स फॉर द सेम। एट द आउटसेट आई वुड लाइक टू फर्स्ट कंग्रेचुलेट डॉक्टर रामदास एंड हिज टीम फॉर ऑर्गेनाइजिंग ए वंडरफुल सेमिनार एज वी ग्रोन टुगेदर एंड आई कैन प्राउडली से दैट is our association about 30 years today. And know his enthusiasm, and when he called me, I actually was reluctant to come here because I am not practicing since July 1st, 2012. But he said you presented a paper sometime back at Chennai. I would like to see what the progress you have made, and some of my students at that time were not happy the way you presented it. I said, then I have to definitely come. There is no option. And he was of the opinion whether the students have really understood the concept, how easy, how difficult to even talk about a CKD. And I thought, let me put forward, I should at the first instance itself convey my apologies to him for not bringing all the cases. I'll be just discussing about 30 cases. I must be definitely having another 30 cases report. If somebody finds time, come to me. You can sit with my other colleague and dig out the data, put it in a form, because it is habitual for me now to treat them than documenting it. But the documents are available. What I mean to say, another 30 definitely I can give you. Anybody is interested can look into it. I'll give the records. But I'll be comparing 15 cases of my middle years of practice and 15 cases of my latter years of practice. And I will openly confess my blunders as an early and immature and immature Ayurvedic physician when I graduated. Okay. Why I'm saying this? These days we are all living under the sentiment of text of Ayurveda. Seldom we are prepared to stand for the acid test. We all live in our comfort zone. Whenever somebody questions, we say Ayurveda, Dasavidha Pariksha, though we not apply even one. A obese person coming to my clinic, I'm not sure whether it's Prakriti or Vikriti. Okay. I should admit it's my ignorance than the lack of science behind it. At least I put it that way. Are we prepared to do that kind of introspection? And I'm not going to preach Ayurveda today, since I was told there are a lot of students coming from different parts of the country. I thought, let me openly confess how this journey started. There are several conditions like this. Maybe this is one of the occasions where I'll be speaking about these experiences. And sometime we are also now working on thyroid disorders. We are now talking about the iodine salt induced hypothyroidism in India, carefully mapping it. Now group of doctors joined me and they are agreeing. Since 1999 and 2009, in 10 years, there is 20-fold increase in hypothyroidism because we are using iodine salt and nobody reports it. Just we are carried away. Iodine is treatment for hypothyroidism. Without understanding, iodine induces hypothyroidism. We are not even ready to debate with modern fraternity with proof, if you have proof. Because 1999, government made it mandatory to use only iodized salt. So before that 10 years and after that 10 years, there is 20-fold increase, and we don't look into the text, what biochemistry says when it comes to hypothyroidism and iodine. So a lot of things. So my point here will be just, I will quickly take you through some of the fundamentals. Since students are also there, it's my responsibility to take you through the fundamentals. And then probably in two parts, I will share my experiences, giving you what should be the approach. Now, what is this, the often spoken chronic kidney disease, CKD? In the earlier years, this is the same thing which we used to discuss as CRF, a chronic renal failure. And why do we discuss this more? If you look at CKD definition, it is any damage or a decreased level of function which is determined through GFR rate, which is divided into about 5 stages. And this is the international criteria which is followed when it comes to the diagnosis. This is how we get the conditioned reflex. No? We are all animals. Once we understand, a reflex can be exhibited. This is the best example. So any damage, if it is there for about 3 months, defined by structure, maybe your CT, ultrasonogram, scintigraph today. But most importantly, when it comes to the diagnosis part, you will be depending upon glomerular filtration rate, which can be diagnosed on the basis of your creatinine. That's what today we say EGFR, the estimated glomerular filtration rate. Anything below 60% is where we start considering these conditions as the CKD. The question is, why are we discussing about it? Is it really having any significance? Definitely. If you look at the entire world, these are available, I will just show it, you can read it. This is how it stands in UK and US. And this is how it stands in India. Any disease having about 8.8%, which is equal to almost 1%, is really going to trouble us. And this is when we are able to diagnose. I have seen a boy of about 4 years who came to me is grade one. Okay. At that age, we have to pray God and have to wait for the response, because he is neither diagnosed with hypertension, nor with diabetes, not your autoimmune kidney disease, nothing else, glomerular nephritis. It is diagnosed. So, love it or leave it. That's the policy. The boy is now free from any of the symptoms, and his ultrasonogram today shows there is absolutely no parenchymal damage. You may believe or may not believe, but I followed Ayurveda. Related to Ashwini, they said in the younger age group, below adolescence age group, sadhya, yoni kruchaha. Maybe that is applicable to these conditions also. The criteria which we have to adopt should have a base. And his father is joining me next week for my Kailash Yatra. Okay. And the boy is without any symptoms, and his creatinine levels are normal now. There is another parameter what I can suggest. Because grade one, you don't get any symptoms. Not at all. And God has only to give you some signal through which you go for a routine examination, you'll come to know. Otherwise, up to sometimes grade three also symptomless. So when they are symptomless, why are we labeling this as Vrukkasodha XYZ? The symptoms are not available. And we always debate why should we use the modern tools of diagnosis. One side, we are reluctant to use the modern tools, saying that Ayurveda doesn't require. The other side, we give Vrukkasodha, Vrukkajanisodha. I'll tell you, a lot of published literature by great scholars. Several titles have been given for chronic renal failures. Several treatments have been attempted. Rogamado Parikshetha Tatonantaramo. That is the protocol. You diagnose as per Ayurveda lines, no problem. You use the modern tools, diagnose, apply Ayurvedic tools, that is also okay. Are we there somewhere in between or not is the question. There are a lot of organizations across the globe which are working. I am leaving this presentation for you. Okay. Now, what are the causes of this kidney disease? Before going to the causes of chronic renal failure or chronic kidney disease, I would like to first of all mention to you that I am not going to talk to you about the acute renal failure. It is a total different story which will be concluded in about sometimes days or weeks time, sometimes less than 1 year. The fate will be decided. It also has all the five stages. So terminal stage, anyway, you will come across in both the cases, but I am not going to talk to you about this. The general causes, as you are aware, is diabetes and hypertension, and then your glomerular nephritis and congenital conditions. Okay, this is how the etiology stands today. The top being diabetes, okay, and next being your hypertension, and not to forget, we are getting a lot of chronic interstitial diseases and autoimmune conditions also. This is how the Indian scenario stands, matching with the global scenario. Okay? And this interstitial nephritis, which is leading to renal failures, and this is glomerular nephritis resulting in renal failures. And these are autoimmune kidney diseases. These days we are getting autoimmune conditions. Maybe it may not be the right platform, but sometime in 2006 I presented a paper at Delhi in one of the international workshops saying that autoimmunity is ojovriddhi. I don't know whether we can understand this or not, but if you have time, I'll send across the paper to you. Carefully think over. In Mahabharata, we have two great characters who fought for about 20 days with each other. One is Bakasura and then the other one is Bhima. Both were having the equal strength when it was in the Ekachatrapura. Instead of sending that boy from his landlord, Bhima went and tried to sacrifice himself. He fought with this giant for about 18 days, ultimately conquered. That means giant was also having the same strength like Bhima, but Bhima was using his strength for good and good cause, and the other one is not. That's how I can simply define. But if you look at Visrantha and Vyapat as the, and Kshaya as three states of Ojas, Visrantha and Vyapat requires Vriddhi. Please read the commentary of Hemadri on Ojas. You will come to know. He was questioning. In fact, he is the only person in the history of Ayurveda who questioned this and said, without Vriddhi, Visrantha and Vyapat are not possible. Kshaya, Maranamitya Kshaya. So, your deficiency leads to death. Immunocompromisation is a state which you can call Visrantha, and Vyapati is the autoimmunity. The three states of your immune system have been mentioned. Are we going to the fundamental level and look at what is happening in each condition? Maybe the concept works here, that's what I want to say, if we apply it clinically. I would like to quickly take you through the five stages. These are the five stages. I am going to talk to you about mostly this spectrum. These days 3B is also there, because where your GFR is about 45 and less. So these are the cases where, according to me, we should not make any attempt to go for specific treatment, because these are the asadhya states. When a disease in the Vyakti state, it is asadhya. When a disease at the Bhedha state, it is the Pratyakshaya. Shushruta clearly mentioned it. So when all the symptoms are surfacing, it is asadhya. Sarvasampurna lakshanaha asadhya. Very simple. So take your fundamentals. When you have studied about Kshatriya Kalas, apply it in clinical practice. We always think that is of no use. You can apply the same Kshatriya Kalas in the metastasis, invasion, when it comes to cancer. You can apply everywhere. These are the fundamental concepts given to you. It's the best tool given to you. Whether you are using it or not is a different story. Okay? As I was mentioning, see here, once it comes down to somewhere between 60 and 80, we will focus on this. And following all the cases up to 45 and less than 15 is where we consider as end-stage renal disease. These are the Kidney Foundation of Canada defines all the five stages. Again, in US also they follow the same trend. In UK, a study reveals the spectrum. And finally, these are the five stages of this thing. If you look at it, always the first stage is about 90-80%. It should be 80% when you should start considering it is stage 1. Then between 60 and 80 we will be taking it to stage 2, and up to 60 we will be taking it as, between 30 and 60 we will be taking it as stage 3. Why I am giving this? I will show you some of the cases. It is not that I have not taken. I have taken terminally ill patients who are on dialysis. I was foolish to start with, because we get our consultation, usually we don't want to forego that. I was also doing the same thing, nothing to hide. But as the time progressed, in my total career, each case was a research for me than a practice. Therefore, I could track what is happening to them, and mostly I was taking the cue from what they mentioned, and what my teachers were pronouncing, and I tried to apply, and in the process I learned a lot of things. Okay, this is what is, which is going to worry us. You cannot even define how much time it takes most of the times. When I reviewed the literature, even it has taken 40 years for a patient to start at stage 1 and reach stage 5. and it has not given even 40 months time in some of the patients. So it all depends upon the other factors like hypertension, diabetes, multiple factors. If they are involved, the prognosis will be poor and progression of the condition is very fast. The progression is what is going to define the stage, and this is a terminal stage which is ultimately going to kill the patient. So what are the symptoms of CKD? Again, as I started mentioning to you, I am not going to discuss about acute renal failure. I am aware your pre-renal, post-renal and intra-renal causes of renal failure, acute. Let us ignore this. Let us proceed. This is very simple. Okay. If you come to the symptoms, at around the second, third stage, 3A, 3B, you see edema, pedal edema, but continuously one thing which you can document is GFR, increase, decrease, and headaches which we usually ignore. Fatigueness is something which usually we ignore, the fatigueness. Why I am saying this? In Kshatriya Kalas, loss of appetite is there in kapha. And Ashmari, again I am taking an example because it is in the spectrum of Mutra Kruchna to your Prameha. If you carefully go through this, starts with kapha. This disease starts with kapha. Prameha is kapha. So Agnimandya is mentioned, that means increased creatinine is resulting in the loss of appetite, which we are ignoring. We thought Ayurveda was quoting Agnimandya and several conditions, so why to focus on Agnimandya here? The very Agnimandya here is indicating the increased creatinine levels. So this is where I want to tell you how to use the modern tools for presenting your own observations to the scientific world. Okay, time and again I'll be saying this because we are living under sentiments. We wear pant and shirt, we use AC rooms, we use all modern. We have urbanized ourselves, but we are leaving Ayurveda in the jungle. We don't want to bring Ayurveda along with us. We want to keep Ayurveda in the forest. We want to live in the urban area. Bring it along with you. Contemporize it. Use it for its best way. I was speaking to an audience at a Medanta hospital last month, where they have 6 Ayurveda doctors who are really working and developing protocols of integration. Integration is not prescribing an allopathic drug and Ayurvedic drug on the same prescription. Integration is using it, their medicine in your gray areas and using your medicines in their gray areas. That's how it should happen, and this is one of the cases. That's why I'll be emphasizing this way in between. Okay, now it takes several years to develop the symptoms, otherwise they are all symptomless. These are the 12 symptoms which you should always remember in your mind. Changes in the urinary function, this may be frequency increased or decreased, which you see in the spectrum what I was mentioning from Mutra Kruchna to Prameha. All are linked. If you carefully open that Mutra Kruchna chapter and see all the 20 Pramehas, like it was discussed, I was about to say, in Shukrameha, we started doing Semanuria. Instead of writing it as Semanuria, directly mentioned by somebody, it is retrograde ejaculation, okay? And simple treatment. I have 6 cases only documented so far. Aupatkar Churan. For me, Thambrul is Aupatkar Churan. If it is diabetes, among the Prameha, only one condition, Madhumeha, I remove the Sita Churan and make my Aupatika Churan, which will be literally bitter, really bitter, but it takes care of even diabetes. I have case reports. Otherwise, the main emphatic indication in the Phalashruti of Aupatika Churana, Jayanti Vinshatin Mehan Nisseshan. Jayanti Vinsatin Mehan Nisseshan. You can take it up. The spectrum, the very purpose of looking at the spectrum, you get the feedback of most of the conditions and difficulty during avoiding this, blood in the urine, hematuria and swelling I mentioned, extreme fatigue is another condition, dizziness and inability to concentrate on issues is another this thing, feeling cold all time and skin rashes and itching when you have high levels of BUN, and then ammonia breath and metallic state, nausea and vomiting, your shortness of breath and pain in the back. This is another important symptom which we ignore. Pain back, mostly we start doing katibasti. Before doing any katibasti, if any person is having back pain of 3 months or plus, please have a ultrasonogram. Why? At least 2 out of 10 you come across these conditions. That kind of prevalence is there today. The statistics, latest statistics suggest that. Okay, as I was mentioning, this is the fully blown picture of your risk factors of CKDs. You can see the end stage of your renal failure is associated with this spectrum which we were discussing, mostly your diabetes and hypertension. And another interesting observations made by some of the scholars. So it looks like dandruff, no? You get carried away. It is a uremic status which has been shown on the forehead, and as a clinician we may ignore. Complications, as I mentioned, and then not to forget the drugs involved in the entire spectrum. Okay. Why we are talking about complications here? They are directly linked with the functions of kidney. People may be on erythropoietin injections when you come to you once they are into stage 3. So what is that we are going to do for them? Maybe some of the earlier scholars, they were administering Punarnava Mandur, because if you look at the published and unpublished experience of clinicians, it will invariably go to Punarnava Mandur. At least I have not come across any physician who had ever seen a case of acute or chronic renal failure not prescribing Punarnava Mandur. But I was doing this, maybe more than 100 cases till 99. I was also administering Punarnava Mandur. I was getting some benefits. I have not quantified my benefits. Sitting in a government setup, just we were administering, we were depending on the clinical symptomatology. Whatever level of improvement that could happen in hemoglobin levels might have made me to get carried away. But slowly, when I started looking at their creatinine profiles, their creatinine profiles are increasing, those who are on Punarnava Mandur. And most of the pharmacies who make Mandur Bhasam, if you look at their, this thing, I don't want to comment, what are the ingredients, you go back and verify the text on the basis of the references given, and you'll come to know. Ethically, I'm not opening it up, otherwise I can say this, off the record you can ask me what is the process involved. You will come to know why the creatinine levels go up. If you keep a track of your own events, it will teach you what is correct and what is incorrect. See, Charak had given you a philosophy, never forget. Natmardham, natikamardham, atapvota dayam prati. Poor fellow, he made 120 chapters for us without even taking the copyrights. Have you ever noticed it? He had not taken copyrights. He had not taken a publication prize. He had given an open book to us, and we are making money out of it, no? That also he realized. Kurvante yetu vrittyardhan chikissa panya vikrayaha tehitva kanchanan rasim pansu rasim upasate. Okay. See, you know, sir, that people like me will be making a lot of money. If you give me TADA, I'll come here. Huh? Okay, otherwise I will not come. All my philosophy disappear. A lot of things are there, no? We live our own purushartha, not for punya. So like that, if you look at each of them, sometimes we may be prescribing things related to calcium, or we may not be giving at all. Look at it. For example, I'll take Vasanta Kusumakar. Vasanta Kusumakar, when I used to prescribe, I used to get relief.